you're in like a once in 28 year peak.
Oh.
And you'll be in it until 2022.
I'm already worried that the peak is gonna be over. What does that
say? Well, as a Virgo, that makes sense.
Yeah.
My name is Chani Nicholas, and this is Star Power. Today, my guest is Amy Poehler.
I have never had my chart read before. I'm so excited.
Well, you're very brave to do this.
You're like, I found some really bad things in.
Yeah. But actually, bravery is one of the main marks of your chart. When we look at somebody's chart, we're looking at the entire sky, like the moment that you took your first breath. When we look to the eastern horizon, we see what sign is rising up over the horizon, and that's what we call the rising sign. And your rising sign, do you know this, what your rising sign is?
Is it Aquarius?
Yes.
And we're in the age of Aquarius. Didn't we just have the great conjunction?
We did, and it was actually right on your ascendant. So I'm wondering how the end of December was for you.
End of December?
Yeah, like mid end of December. Did it feel like a kind of shift?
Yeah, very much.
Yeah.
Very, very much.
Yeah, so that great conjunction happened right, like exactly on your ascendant. And what is an ascendant about? An ascendant is about what we want to be known for. So when you have an Aquarius ascendant, you want to be known for your intellect. When we meet you, there's this feeling or impression of, oh wow, this person's ideas are going to make a mark on the world, or that's the thing that you would most want. And so Aquarius is always the visionary.
This is really good for my ego.
You're in like a once in 28 year peak.
Oh.
And you'll be in it until 2022.
That doesn't give me a lot of time. I'm already worried that the peak is gonna be over. What does that
Well, about? As a Virgo, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Well, the last peak period was 1993.
Oh, wow.
Did anything significant happen around 93?
Graduated from college, yeah. And I moved to Chicago to start performing, and met a lot of the people that shaped my life in comedy.
So this is a kind of like second go around of that period. And the periods like this are meant to be full of people and full of exchanges. And it's a time where you look back to about 2004 and see what happened around 2004 as a kind of seeding of potential. At this point in your life, like you're in a different position than you were last time it happened. Last time it happened, you were just out of college. And so you were just like getting your life together and like, what is the big world and what does it mean to be an adult? And now on this side of things, you get to kind of look back at that whole time frame and take all of that experience and all of that wisdom and make it manifest for something that has a lot more wisdom and a lot more depth to it, I think.
How cool. Do I get a bonus year because of COVID?
Yeah, totally.
Great.
That's in the contract.
2020 didn't quite be as filled with people as maybe I would have liked.
Right underneath the horizon in your chart, we find Mars. Mars is the planet of action and courage. So Mars in the first house, like you have, denotes a leader. Your Mars is also attached to like a really big hunger. As a young person, and also as somebody who is gendered, where maybe girls are supposed to be nice and quiet, what do you do with this really ferocious appetite for knowledge and taking action? And there is a real revolutionary and rebellious spirit that is attached to this part of your chart. I watched Moxie and I wanted to cry the whole time. I just felt like, as a Gen Xer myself, to watch the ways in which you integrated our generation and what we had to work with and the spirit of that whole movement and what it means to be part of this lineage of feminism was really beautiful.
I'm really glad you liked it. Thank you. Well, it's so interesting when you talk about things coming back around. If you're speaking about there's a period in the chart that says these are some special years, I feel like the film is about coming back around, but what have you learned?
Yeah.
And more importantly, what do you have to unlearn?
Yes.
That's a lot of what our generation is being asked to do.
And right now, Jupiter, the planet of abundance and expansion, is transiting, it's going over your Mars, so it's magnifying it. And that's 1 in 12 year kind of cycle. Mm-hmm. So as you're putting out this movie, that is about taking action. This planet of abundance and expansion is going over that part of your chart. Also, you're a Virgo sun.
Well, this is what's so funny, because I am a Virgo and I really identify. And when I found out that my rising sign was Aquarius, it was very late in my life, because I've never had this done before. And I couldn't believe it. I mean, I just identify as such an earth sign, yeah, and took such pride in it. And, you know, Virgos believe they're the best. I mean, Beyonce is a Virgo, enough said. So I've had to let go of some of my Virgo identity, and it's been interesting. But yes, please go on.
I think that there's a lot of similarities actually between Virgo and Aquarius. Mm. Both signs are so appreciative of the facts, mm, and of data and of research. So while they're very different, I think that they both very much appreciate the integrity of intelligence. And Virgo loves a system.
I love a system.
Loves a system. Mm. Any kind of organizing situation, yeah, that helps us make sense of life, mm, that helps us do our work efficiently and, yeah, effectively, yeah, that gives also context to what is so messy, which is life. Also, you have your sun right next to an asteroid called Hygieia, which is actually where we get the word hygiene. And so I thought it was funny because
that's so funny.
Known for being really clean and loving things
as
organized.
Everyone should. Please make it a point to be known for your cleanliness.
I was looking at the rest of your chart and I was like, oh, this could be the chart of like a doctor or somebody who.
This is a dream come true. All I've done is watch ER over quarantine. I feel like I'm a doctor.
And then you've got the moon in Leo. Mm. And your moon in Leo, again, loves the applause. It, yeah, is here to shine. It is here to give to the people. And you actually have this signature with your moon where your Mars is really ambitious. It needs to be a go-getter. Like, you need to have succeeded in whatever field you chose. Your moon is actually incredibly generous and just wants to give a lot of it away. So we've got, again, this straddling of real difference here, where the moon will be able to infuse whatever room it goes into with its light and its ability to be entertaining. And I think Leo really is that fire that we gathered around as early, early humans and told stories.
This has been such a gift. I didn't know any of this.
There's a ton more, but I think it's really the perfect movie to launch, actually, with this signature, because, again, it only comes around once every 12 years, and it's happening right now.
Mm. Oh my, I have work to do.
Also, Mars is in charge of your career, so.
Oh, Mars is in charge of my career?
Yeah.
Good, because I need to talk to Mars, because Mars owes me some money. Mars is a badass.
Very.
I'm going to play this on a loop in my car. when I need a boost.